It may not be obvious, but film grain is such an important part of photography and retouching. I use it all the time, but I needed better tools to be able to produce it, so I created GrainLab. I want to show you the preset looks, the most classic film grain looks for me that I use in my work. We've included them in GrainLab as presets. So if you don't want to go in and mess around and create your own grain in GrainLab, we have a bunch of presets. You can just click a button and go. So in GrainLab, I'm going to bring up a new GrainLab group by clicking new. And let's zoom in a little. You can see an image like this really benefits from some film grain. It just gives it a little bit more of a narrative quality or cinematic quality. It also gives it a feeling of surface. And it can help a vintage style photograph look even more vintage. Now this is pretty subtle. You can see here the quality of the grain. The cool thing about GrainLab though is that our presets are right here and you can throw them on just with a touch of a button. So this is light tooth and it's just what it sounds like. It's much more of a light surface. Let's try T-Max. Now that's much of a sharper and larger grain. Now notice with dual scale mode turned on, there's a different quality of grain in the highlights than there is in the shadows. And if you open up the folder, you can see you can turn off the highlight grain or the shadow grain. And if you want to turn dual scale off, go ahead and cancel. That removes your GrainLab layer set. Turn it off and create a new GrainLab layer group. Now we've got one scale of grain over the whole image. Let's try 16 millimeter coarse. Now that's a big, big grain. And pretty soft. 35 millimeter coarse. It's a nice light touch. I really love a grain like this for a vintage feeling image. And if you want a finer version of that, that is a really subtle touch. And finally, the 8. This is really a large, soft grain. And it doesn't work on an image like this for me. It looks really bizarre in the skin. I don't like that. But that's why we've included these in GrainLab with all of the controls. So you can change all the qualities of this preset grain. I definitely want to reduce the size of it because it's all the way up at 100. Let's reduce it by half. Ooh, that's getting a lot nicer. Maybe just the amount itself could come back because I want a subtle grain on this image. I'm going to reduce the roughness a bit. The size even more, down to 25. I'm going to bring the defocus down a bit. Defocus basically just softens the grain. And the amount back up so we can see it better. And that looks really nice. This is what I wanted GrainLab to do well, was start with a preset and then let you adjust all the settings to your taste. Click OK. Now, lots of times I'll have multiple grain in my image for different purposes. I'll set it back to light tooth and create a new grain lab. So that added a really fine surface grain right on top. I'm going to crank it up so we can see it better for this demonstration. There, that's pretty strong. I'm going to click OK. And you can see you have multiple grains that you can turn on, off, or even change the opacity. So you can see with GrainLab, we've built in some presets for a lot of different conditions, whether you want to create a vintage look or add a modern surface to product or automotive photography, you can just quickly generate that with GrainLab presets.